हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज़ प्रायोन्स, राइट? प्रायोन्स कॉन्स्टिट्यूट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ग्रुप ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, दैट्स व्हाई इट्स स्टडी हैज़ बीन इंक्लूडेड इन माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. दिस टॉपिक प्रायोन वी विल कवर अंडर फोर हेडिंग्स इन टुडेज क्लास. फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन, सेकेंड हिस्ट्री, थर्ड सिग्निफिकेंस एंड फोर्थ मोड ऑफ एक्शन, राइट? सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट स्टार्ट अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट. Okay, when we are saying prions, always remember prions, if I say prions are proteins, right? What are prions? Prions are proteins. But now question comes in our mind, if prions are proteins, then why we are not using the term proteins for this particular group of microorganisms? Why we are saying prions? Of course, these proteins of prions are somewhat different from normal protein. How? Because they don't behave like normal proteins. Their functions don't resemble normal proteins, because prions proteins, the proteins which constitute prions, they are of infectious type, or I can say they are able to cause various type of infections, right? So infectious proteins particle are known as what? Are known as prions. Okay, and most of the times you will be finding that prions study has been given under virology section, right? If we talk about virology, of course everybody is knowing that virology is a branch of biology which includes a study of viruses, right? And if we talk about viruses, viruses are made up of what? They are nucleoprotein particles, okay? They are made up of nucleic acid and they are made up of proteins. So most of the times you will be finding, whenever we are going through any basic microbiology book, general microbiology book, then under virology chapter this topic prions has been introduced, right? So what is the connection that prions are generally studied as a part of virology? Because it has been found the biochemistry of prions, that is their proteinaceous nature, it resembles what? It resembles viruses. If we talk about viruses, in viruses they are having nucleic acid and proteins. And suppose in viruses mutation occurred due to some reasons and nucleic acid is removed, then what can remain only? Proteins. Maybe these are a kind of mutated viruses, or these are the viruses which are the origin of prions. That's why mostly under virology section we study prions topic, right? Now, so again, we can quickly revise it. Introduction part, prions stands for what? Proteins. But these proteins are of which type? These are not normal proteins, these are infectious proteins which are able to cause various kind of diseases. Okay, that's why they are different from the normal proteins. And secondly, most of the times they are giving under virology section because their biochemistry is going to resemble with what? Viruses, with regard to the proteinaceous nature. Okay, so this was about the introduction part. I can say a brief introduction about the prions, right? We will be further going in detail that what is the significance and what is the mode of action of prions. But before that, of course, if we have taken any new topic like prions, we are going to take here. So history is very important part. The introduction part is done for everyone now. Now we are coming towards history part, right? In history, we should know, of course, who was the researcher, who was the scientist, in which year the prions were actually discovered. Then we should make our understanding clear about it, that in 1982 there was a scientist named as Stanley B. Prusiner, right? Stanley B. Prusiner was the researcher, was a scientist who first of all identified gene. Okay, gene coding for what? Protein which is of what? Infectious nature, right? So this Stanley B. Prusiner, this scientist or researcher, I can say, identified the gene which is responsible for coding a protein, and the protein which in turn was responsible for coding what? For causing various kind of diseases or for some infectious nature, and later on it was called as what? Prion protein, right? Later on it was called as prion protein. So this is I can say a brief historical background that how prions were discovered or prion proteins were discovered. Now we should also update our knowledge that in 1997, the same researcher got Nobel Prize, or we can say he was awarded with Nobel Prize for his very important discovery on prion proteins. So this is a very important information regarding historical background of prions. I hope it is clear to you all. 1982, Stanley B. Prusiner was the researcher who identified gene coding for protein, and which protein was of infectious nature and known as prion protein. And in 1997, for his major contribution on the prions, this researcher was awarded with Nobel Prize, right? So this was about the historical background of prions. Now we are moving towards significance. So significance is very important whenever we are going to study any microbial group, right? It is only the significance that why we are going to include this topic in microbiology study. Of course, prions are having some significant importance. If I say, we are now very well clear, prions, let's take it again, are what? Infectious protein. Right, infectious protein particles, which are able to cause what? Which are able to cause infections. And these infections caused by them can result into what? Diseases. Okay. And remember, this is their importance and significance in microbiology, why prions have been included as an important microbial group in microbiology, because of their ability to cause diseases. Now question comes, they cause which type of diseases and what are the host, right? So first thing is clear to us, diseases are the main reason which are resulting from the prions. Now question comes, what kind of diseases? So they are able to cause diseases in human and they are able to cause diseases in animals. Remember, these are the host, I can say, which are targeted by prions. And till date, remember, no disease has been reported for plants. Means prions are not able to cause disease in plants. They are able to cause diseases in mammals, especially human and animals. So I hope it is clear to you, significance part. We will again be taking some more points on diseases. What kind of diseases, what are the name of these diseases? So this is so clear to everyone, right? Now question comes, what are the diseases? What are the name of those diseases which are caused by prions, right? Diseases is clear, they are going to cause diseases in human and animals. Now remember, diseases caused by prions, what are the names of diseases? So there is one disease which is known as mad cow disease, right? Mad cow disease, it is also known as bovine spongiform encephalopathy, right? What it is known as? Bovine spongiform encephalopathy, right? Why it is called as bovine spongiform encephalopathy? Bovine animals, as it is clear from the disease, mad cow disease in bovine animals it occurs. Then spongiform, what happens when under microscopic examinations, targeted tissues of animals which are infected by prions are examined, then they look like sponges. Sponge type areas are generally reported or observed under microscopic examination of infected tissue. Then secondly, we should know there is another disease known as scrapie. Scrapie, it is a disease which is caused in sheep by prions. Third disease you can remember here, kuru, right? It is caused in human, right? Then chronic wasting disease, it is in chronic wasting disease in deer, right? So these are some of the diseases we can learn about. Now remember, the diseases, all the diseases together caused by prions, for those diseases this term is used, transmissible spongiform encephalopathies, right? Like this, spongiform encephalopathy, that all the diseases together caused by prions are called as transmissible spongiform encephalopathy. as I have written here, right? Encephalopathy. So these are all together called as TSEs. Now remember, so many of us can say that we have rarely heard about these diseases, or the occurrence rate of these diseases or the infections caused by prions is not that much common. Then you are right, you are true, because the diseases caused by prions, they are rarely caused, right? They are not so common like other microbial groups. Like diseases caused by bacteria are very common, diseases caused by fungi, viruses are very common, but prions diseases are not that much common. They are a kind of rare disease, but still we should update our knowledge that what happened in 1990s, mad cow disease, what we have earlier studied, mad cow disease resulted in an outbreak, right, in 1990. Where this outbreak occurred? This outbreak occurred in Britain, right? In Britain, an outbreak was reported because of mad cow disease. And what happened? It was found when the meat from infected cow or diseased cow, meat from diseased cow animals was consumed by human, it has led to another disease in them. What is the name of that disease? It was Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, right? It was Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. And due to this disease, more than 90 people were dead at that time in UK and France. Right? So what we want to learn from here, this is indicating the significance of this microbial group prions. So, and significance, very importantly, we are studying also, we can say this is a part of history which is indicating the significance. In 1990s, what happened? Mad cow disease occurred. It has led to an outbreak and also resulted in an epidemic where large population of cows or bovine animals were affected in Britain. And when the meat of this cow was eaten by a human, then this resulted in another variant which is known as Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, which was actually originated from the mad cow disease. So this is going to tell us the importance or significance, right? One more thing we will be updating now to our database, that all the diseases what we have studied, diseases which are caused by prions, they result in what? They lead to brain damage. Right, they lead to what? Brain damage, or we can say they affect the functioning of neurons. Neurons functioning is affected by, or we can say it they don't properly work in the presence of prions, right? When prions are going to attack a particular host, then it will result in automatically brain damage. So what is the mode of action? How prion proteins result in brain damage? How it leads to disruption of neuronal functions? This part now we are covering under mode of action heading, right? So let's take now mode of action part. So now significance is done for everyone. Now we are coming for mode of action, right? So in mode of action, you should remember in two parts we will be learning it, right? One is host cell and other one is what? Prion protein, right? Prion protein. Host cell, here I am going to tell you about host neuronal cell. Host neuronal cell is going to produce these are host neuronal cell. They produce what? They produce a protein, right? This protein is a glycoprotein, right? It is a glycoprotein, and we use a term PrPC for these proteins. PrPC proteins, these are produced by neuronal cell of host under normal conditions. Okay, under normal condition when everything is okay. And now we are talking about prion protein. Prions, of course, they are already a protein. PrPSC. PrPSC type of protein are coded by what? Prions. SC word has been taken from Scrappy. Scrappy, the prion protein which is responsible for causing Scrappy. But remember, most of the prions work in the same way. Prion protein act in the same way. Means they will be affecting what? Neuronal functions, right? So let's come towards the mode of action. How prion protein act on host neuronal cell? Okay, so normally we are already clear about it, PrPC is there. When prion protein act on host cell, what it will be doing? The host cell protein PrPC, these are PrPC host cell protein, these will be converted into PrPSC. When the prion protein will attack on host cell, okay, it means these will be now converted into abnormal form, PrPSC form, and abnormal form cannot carry out the host proper function. It cannot act like normal neuronal cells, and neurons are mainly involved in brain in synapses. We are clear that neuronal cells communicate with each other by interacting at certain junctions, that is known as synapses. So I can say when this is going to PrPC is going to convert into PrPSC, then synapses will be disrupted. Synapses in the brain will be disrupted, and it will be leading to what? Brain damage. Okay, and I can say neurological symptoms or disorders can appear, which will be causing the death of the host. Okay, so this was about the mode of action. Again, we can quickly take a revision of this. Host cell under normal condition, their neuronal cell, it is going to produce a protein, which I have tried to show here in circular form, that is called as the glycoprotein. It is labeled as PrPC. Okay, and prion protein in its normal condition, it is known as PrPSC. Remember one thing what I missed there, PrPC and PrPSC, both proteins are having same amino acid sequence. Okay, both proteins are having what? Same amino acid sequence, but they are changed in their folding. It is folded in this way, and it is folded in some other way, and folding is responsible for deciding the function of protein. Okay, so I can again explain you this point in more clear way. So I hope mode of action up to this point though is clear to everyone. PrPC, host cell protein, when it is reacted with PrPSC, prion protein, this is host cell protein, right? This is prion protein, this is host cell protein. Both have same amino acid, but folding is, folding of protein is changed, and folding is the main factor which affects the functioning of protein. So what will be happening when prion protein PrPSC will act on PrPC? It will convert what? It will convert prion protein PrPC of host cell into prion protein. And what will be happening? Host neurons, they will not work, and ultimately it will be leading to what? Neurons damage, or I can say neurological disorders. So this was all about prions, right? I hope mode of action is clear to you all, and remember for this lecture, so that you can revise it again and you can check your concepts, whatever you have retained through this lecture, you can wait for my next video that I'll be uploading soon, in which I am going to share about MCQs on prions, okay, of same lecture. This lecture based MCQ I am going to share in next class. So thanks a lot and keep watching.